we have a few different components of our dynamic warm-up. One is there's like almost the general warm-up portion of that. Sometimes guys will start on the bike for 5 or 8 minutes at the most, just to loosen up and get their brains wrapped well around what's going on and get that sort of that pattern going, get a little bit of blood flow, get a little bit of heart rate up. We'll do some knee to chest movements, some high knee steps, lunge walk, reverse lunge, some shuffling, some moving in both a sort of a linear as well as a lateral movement patterns. We'll do like an inchworm or I think I've heard it, I think it's called an inchworm in most world, but an inchworm exercise. So we're trying to basically get a lot of the joints moving, get the joints activated correctly, get muscles lengthened and warmed up and ready for movement. Once we get that, then we'll specifically activate muscle that we're using that day, whether it's some glute work we have to do, whether it's some upper back, some rhomboids, you know, that type of stuff as well. Guys roll out often before that. They'll roll out muscles that are tight from previous workouts just to prep them. Sometimes we'll have issues where we'll do some release prior to the workout as well to make sure that any muscle knots or muscle bundling or nerve bundling that's going to affect the workouts is out of there so we can get true movement and get our movements to be more correct. The triangle drill for me is probably one of my favorite drills. Now, specifically for defensemen, I look at it, it absolutely emulates a penalty kill situation, but also for any guy in the penalty kill, it emulates that sort of short movement burst and return back into your locked position or your sort of coach position. But what I love about it is responding to coach's cue, players are moving, and having to follow that under a little bit of fatigue. I pulled the triangle out and lengthened them about probably about 2.5-3 feet after a few warm-up drills with him and made him work in about a 2-4 step movement. So it was a more than just a quick lunge position. It was a 2-4 steps in a direction and back to his return position. So getting after loose pucks, and if you miss it, get back in the position, or if you get it, making your next step. So basically that return or a direction change as well. The Roman deadlift to the RDL is one of those exercises that I think is in probably every coach's toolbox. It's a great posterior chain exercise, hamstring, low back, glute dominant exercise, and then the pulling motion. I like it for all those reasons. I like the fact that we're seeing great shoulder scap packing, so scapular packing and shoulder blade stability for the athlete as they're holding a lot of weight under their body, having to have those shoulder blades nice and strong, and then to be able to produce a lot of strength and power through the hamstrings and low back glutes.
Three reps.
We do a rope pull. We use like a 2-inch diameter, 3-inch diameter, basically marine cut rope as basically a rope pull up. The athlete's having to handle the grip associated with that and to hold on to something.
All the way down. If you're gonna be on video, I'll stretch yourself.
The inverted row is the horizontal progression of a pull up action. So we'll often combine that with the vertical pull, like a pull up, or we'll do them on separate days and have a vertical pull day and a horizontal pull day. Using the weight again, that's been something we progressed to from using body weight. Inverted rows often will have physio balls under their feet. We can change that. We can have a bench under their feet. At this point, we use their sort of their legs at a bent position, like to keep fairly parallel with their body. Today they used a little bit of weight. They had some weight either hanging off a belt or with a weight vest. To get to that point, we've done a lot of pull-ups over the summer, over the off-season, to develop enough strength. We use the Kaisers for a lot of different things, and with the Kaiser functional machines, it allows for a ton of exercises. What we did today was, at a little bit of higher velocity or in a power movement, we're trying to strengthen some of the pulling and those muscles that are involved in scap retraction and sort of shoulder development at a higher speed, so trying to develop quicker movements through that so they can handle when it, because in the sport things happen at a high speed with a lot of resistance. So we're trying to do things that quickly to help protect the body against any injury in case of battling. And if you do things slow and all of a sudden in your sport you have to do something quickly, that's one of the things where you tend to lose.
Fast, power, come on. No movement, no swing, let's go. Your shoulders a little better, man.
Confidence. Yeah, well, you got the race
to go. After we're getting through a bunch of pretty decent primary lifts, we went into that secondary complex that involved as much as we could single leg action, so using one leg often as an anchor and the other leg as an action. So from our using the valve slides to do a reverse lunge, and focusing on really pulling through our body, through our hips, returning to a standing position. We added just to get more volume of back, so just alternating bent over roll with the dumbbells. And by adding sort of a few exercises like that together, it allows us to get a little more volume and hit the body a little bit harder while we need to get, you know, while working on getting sort of that whole body workout going on. We tend to have our primary exercises separated, and when I have to, especially when we're skating a lot, we'll complex some of our secondary exercises.
Grab some weights. Come on, pull, keep your hips aligned, control this, let's go. Now strong enough, reps. Fuck, other guys can do that. I see other guys pull without having to do that. Come on, keep your hips. You know what you're doing? You know what I'm talking about?
No, I'm doing it.
Sure, I'm gonna
What?
So if you want to sneak in some fucking curling?
curling?
This is a Canadian joke. They always say Canadian. I can't work Canadian. You can't do Canadian without that. Keep pressure on that backslide. You're taking your pressure off of the single leg squat. Make sure you're pulling full pressure. That's better.
When you're doing your workout today, you can do your thumbs up.
And elbows slightly down so you're not so high to your elbows. Elbows in. Now do your lateral one, sideways one. Sideways.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's impossible.
Oh, I know.
You're
an awesome. Then you look at that 45 degree angle one, and go ahead and do a straight or wide one as well. Good. Good at it. Good. Three for side and three together, same arm. Five of those, that's up. Five. Take those out of your pocket. I see you guys.
And that's going to be over here.
We focus first on a little bit of a dead bug rolling pattern. And so we're in a dead bug position, getting him to keep his chain closed from his elbow to his knee. Focus on as much pressure as you can there while rotating his body and basically rolling over. So I think it's more or less stolen, a little bit of a poor version of a stolen exercise from Gray Cook's FMS program. At the same time, I like it for our athletes as far as teaching A to be able to hold the proper glute position and core position and having the strength and the true sort of the true core strength. And so it's a tough exercise. I know they didn't like it too much today. And our guys weren't very happy. Ebs wasn't very happy about it, but it was a good exercise for him today. And then the sequencing of movements that are forced in like a primary roll pattern, and adding that to a dead bug is just more of a challenge for him and more components for him to deal with.
We don't do this. My guys, my fucking pull the hip.
There you go.
Never fucking
pull
this
to
come on. Come on, keep it. Bracing it.
That's the hide the face from the strangler, roll over in the morning when you're being quiet. She doesn't know you're leaving. The crash specialty.
Do that again. Put that on tape. His wife needs to see that shit. Come on, look at, yeah, space. Up here.
She knows.
You're not your
people. Yeah, roll over.
Well, don't use your legs to kick you up. Slow and control the whole way. Walk it through your arm. Reach the arm.
Yeah.
kick under the leg, don't kick up the knees. Use that pressure and body control. Pressure and body control. Relax your chin.
Okay.
No, dead close. Next one. Elongate through your arms. Right. Heel arm as long as possible. Stretch. Long stretch.
Yeah. Press, what do you call this one?
And then you have
I think it's just like a no idea. Maybe a roll pass. Thumbs up. Or a dead bug roll
back. Remember those that we got over? Thumbs up. No, I'm not before jumping.
Oh, with the back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll do a bunch of big bunch of stuff.
Sled pushes is something that I haven't done a ton in the past, and I'm kind of fought it a little bit. We've done other things similar to that. So this year we broke into the sleds, and the guys like them. They do like them. So first and foremost, they're happy with them. They hate doing them. They like the way that it feels. So we're getting a high level of lactic acid buildup in some of the things we're doing. It's causing on the actual conditioning component to it. It's tough. It's a battle. Sometimes it's the mental side of that, learning how to push through it and not give up. I think there's a key component there, right there. Being very careful to keep and not mess up like form. I think when we do too much sled work, too heavy a weight, you'll see guys and they're they're stepping in the running positions. And I saw it a bit today even where they're still battling to keep their form as correct as possible. We also use the sled to do some ankle mobility work where you're pushing low and you're going through a range of motion. So you're going a little slower. You saw Mike early on going a little slower to warm up through his calves and his ankles and strengthen through his calves and soleus muscles and that in a low position. So that those are things that we will do as well. We've done using a harness and a chest harness. We'll do a backwards walk, a VMO activation exercise using the sleds as well.
Yeah.